Frank has visited, had returned to London in the previous chapter, went to the British Museum and got his treasures appraised, found out the Ming was ruined, cracked, and not worth £2 million he thought it might have been. And he talked with Tony, who gave his philosophy on the semi-conscious man and then disappeared. Frank's wandered around in London, went to Edwin's, where he attended the party for the Highgate Rumba. And if we go south, this is where we were, but he was given a note that said, you're not welcome here, and a one-way airfare to New York City. But I thought I'd take a second and just go back to the mansion and just check this out again, just because this was kind of a fun part of the game. Walking through the leafy courtyard lane, the reception hall, the parlor, the crystal ball, and the not-so-secret secret room. Let's see if there's any more interaction here before we bench. Cozy bench in the arbor. The hedges. C-103, a dark and spooky plot cemetery. The statue of Karl Marx. Back to well, there's no more interaction with Edwin. There's no more interaction at Tony's place, and the cab driver's here in London to take us to the airport. So let's look at him, and he says to Frank, "Everything okay, friend? Take me to Liverpool, please. Off to Wembley Stadium, and hurry, please. Just take me to Heathrow Airport." Let's go off to Wembley Stadium. No? Yeah. You take the wrong answers and that doesn't help you, of course. So yeah, it's off to Heathrow. He finds a free ticket to New York in Edwin's Chelsea flat. Well, you want to call it a free ticket. It was basically to tell Frank to get lost. We look at the United Airlines counter, flying the somewhat friendly skies. So let's use the gift, the ticket. And when we do that, we start in London, and fly back, and we're back into New York City, LaGuardia Airport, scene number 79. And Frank's put his Adidas soccer bag down here, and look at the broken Ming vase. After three planes over three continents, the vase is simply a pile of shards. That's a drag. Let's pick up our pile of shards. So he ditches the soccer bag at this point. He's got the broken vase and the other stuff, but no soccer bags. And at the airport, he puts all this stuff, looks and sees a Hertz car. Circles JFK 3 hours in traffic, then out to Westchester and Billy's Scarsdale Cottage. So, back out to Scarsdale. Back out to Billy, his friend. His poet friend. We go back west. We're traveling in this Hertz rental car now, so we're driving up to Scarsdale. Here's Yonkers. Again, we're not going there, we're going to Billy's home. And there is Billy's home. And there's the ex-Jaguar still there. That was the car we drove across country from Berkeley. Tony and Frank did. We look at it now. It says, I guess Billy purchased the title, so that's Billy now. And look at his driveway. It looks like a European pre-owned car lot. Well, let's put our rental there and see what interaction we get. Okay, at which point Billy comes out. And he's catching up with Nixon's resignation, Emmett Grogan's overdose on the last train to Brooklyn, Peter Berg's fantasy of yuppie urban ecology. We can go in Billy's house. And now we're in scene 80. the patio behind Billy's home. And we look at him. They're playing non-stop gin on the patio, drinking Tom Collins with a twist of lime. Let's play gin. Billy's married now. He proposed after a weekend in Bimini when they found Diane's dead cat stinking up the Murphy bed. Well, this is Diane coming to meet the two guys there. Billy's wife. She's a busty Ohio blonde with a modern architectural talent for erotic extortion. You are Diane. Curvaceous Diane looking at Billy and his friend Frank. So we look at Frank. She carries kryptonite in her designer purse to deconstruct potential threats from Billy's maverick friends. Alright, deal it in. Let's play gin. No? Let's see. Well, let's speak to Frank. Her light conversation and bright hospitality anticipate poisoned compliments with a pillow under her hips. And now we're Frank. He looks at her. To Diane. Frank's slipping a confrontation when he has a flash of counterplay. So Frank pulls out a little black book of phone numbers. Let's look at that. To Billy. He says to Billy, "May I use your phone?" And he's going to call. Wow, one of these numbers in the black book. We have Angelica, Astrid. Angelica was the strawberry blonde from Munich, from that he met in Milan. Astrid was the girl at Cuda Beach. Desi from California. Aaron, University of Oregon. Gertrude, he left her in Hong Kong. Letizia in Milan. Luann, of course, that was in the last one in Singapore. Melinda, that was, just trying to remember her. That was Illich's girl in London. Rita, that was in Paulo, the cab driver in Milan, that was his girl. And then Steffi, that would have been Toby's girlfriend in Cologne. Let's see, does Tony have a girlfriend? Well, he had a girl at the Highgate Rumba, but she's not in this list. So, one of these, let's call our old flame, Aaron. No? All right. How about Angelica from Start the Top? No? The girl in Cuda Beach. I don't know about Desi, that was the one, the cop from Berkeley. Let's skip her. Gertrude, let's see, she's got money. Let's see if she wants to come to America. No Gertrude. Letizia. And he calls Letizia in Milan. Invites her for a grand tour of the States, maybe Mexico and Costa Rica. Nice. All right. She was a pretty hot one. Let's go west. And I'll wait for Letizia's arrival. But Frank's rolling out here now. Leaves Diane and Billy. He has to get back in the car though, right? Yeah, okay, so he gets in the car. And he's gonna drive down to the airport to meet Letizia. She hasn't arrived yet, of course, so let's go north now. And this takes us up north to the township of Scarsdale, New York. And back to the Woolworths, where we bought the Visine for the, getting the red out. But now, in the Woolworths, there's glue, adhesive. And it says, good old Elmer should do the trick. Oh, okay. So let's take the glue. And look at the Ming vase. Okay, and we're going to glue this thing back together. And now it's a glued Ming vase. Let's look at that. Not fooling anyone, but what else can you do? All right, so we have a vase glued together. Kind of fake, but at least it's in one piece. Let's take that. And let's go west. We can go west again. And that puts us in scene number 81, the famous White Plains Antiques and Curiosities. And in here, there's Rosenwald, an art dealer. Let's look at him. The art dealer is an old friend of Billy's. Let's show him the treasures. Turkish art. Okay, not that one. How about the vase? And when you show him the Ming vase, Rosenwald, you sign over the Turkish blue vase, 20 Taoist art pieces in the Ming vase. So, Rosenwald now has all these. We're not carrying all this porcelain around anymore. After gluing 33 shards back into a demon dog vase, he parks his Chinese antiques with Rosenwald in Scarsdale. Alright, so it's just him in the car. Is that it? And it's only interaction with Rosenwald. Okay. Alright, let's go south. Let's see if, the son of Atija. There's a horse racing in the den. Let's go with the Billy's. Swap the Jaguar. The Hertz car off. And now at Billy's, there's a new direction just adjacent around the corner from the entrance to his house. A northeast. Scene number 82. A quaint little herb garden. And he smokes a camel in the garden, meditating on the strangeness of the trip, the strangeness of this American gate. Billy appears in the garden next to his house. Letizia called. She's waiting for you at the airport. All right. So let's get back in the car. And let's go down. And there she is, Letizia in LaGuardia. Letizia shows in 48 hours. Frank's ready to go. Alright. Alright, so let's head back here now. Let's see if the Billy and Diane are into a little swinging action here. But now it's Billy and Letizia playing gin, smoking cigarettes and drinking sangria. Not really. So we're back at the patio. Saludos, amigo Rinke. Now let's play gin. She's got him by the balls. They play through the sticky Havana night and pastel morning haze, filling the wine glasses with fat ashes and crushed Marlboro wrappers. You're Billy. He looks at Letizia. Billy stands up. And that's the herb garden here that's backed out the knockers here. But here's a new direction. And that puts us in scene number 83, a small office in Billy's home. So Billy leaves the patio, heads into the house to his office. He's up to something. And there's an office phone. And he can make a phone call. He doesn't have a little black book, but he can call the police, call the travel agent, call for pizza delivery. Let's do that. No? Yeah. Didn't think so. Let's call the police. No? Alright, let's call the travel agent. To Billy. Hey, Mr. Collins. Where are you going off to? Book me a round trip to London, please. I need a one-way ticket to Milan ASAP. How about two train tickets to Philadelphia? All right, let's buy a one-way ticket to Milan ASAP and get to send Letizia back. It's not that. Call the travel agent. A round trip to London. Okay, let's go back there. It's not that either. So it must be a Philadelphia trip. How about two train tickets to Philadelphia? To Billy. No problem. The tickets will be at will call. Great. That is what I was hoping to hear. When Billy gets even, he buys them tickets on the noon train. Pulls Frank masonically aside and says... Oops. What's he gonna say to Frank? Frank goes, "You want us to leave?" Let's speak to Frank. "I love Diane. I'm happy teaching at Lehman College. I'm cutting out some characters she doesn't like. When you marry middle class, you'll understand. Next time you're in New York, pass me by." Oh, Frank just... It's been chilly for Frank over in London. It was kind of chip chilly with his buds, and pretty much the same story back in the States. So where Frank basically told in a kind, gentlemanly way to get lost. He looks at Billy, and Billy goes to Frank. "Oh, and Frank, I'm sorry." "Oh, and Frank, yes, Billy." "The girl can play." "Of course she can." "No?" "Oh, and Frank?" "Yes, Billy." "The girl can play. You'll keep track of the porcelain for me." "Absolutely. Rosenwald is impeccable." "Good luck with Diane." "No?" "Oh, and Frank?" "Yes, Billy." "The girl can play. You'll keep track of the porcelain for me." "Absolutely. Rosenwald is impeccable." "Good luck with Poker Face," which is a book penned by Billy Collins. "Frank." "And you?" And Frank goes, "I haven't written anything for years," or "I'm living too hard to write." That sounds like him. At which point the gin on the patio ends, and it's Frank and Letizia, and they'll have to split. And it's going to be just those two for a bit, as he's no longer welcome in New York. So he gets in the rental and drives back. He's got two train tickets as a gift from Billy to get out of New York. So let's take the car back to... Guardia, and that's the rental car return. Just leave the keys in the drop box and you're off. Let's just drag the car. And when you do, the car is gone. You're out of the car. But you can go south. Now we're in scene 84, New York Grand Central Station. And I guess he caught a cab from there to there. It's not much point, really. The will call window, right? This is where the ticket should be. And they ask Frank, "The names of your party, please." Mr. and Mrs. Frank Wendover, Billy Collins, and Letizia Vanni. Let's try that one. So Billy's gone. Let's try the other one, Mr. and Mrs. Frank Wendover. Charming and fake. The porter. Look at the porter. And the porter says, "All aboard." So they're on this train out of Grand Central. And they're taking the train down to Philadelphia. So Billy's gone. They ramble to Philly throwing dice. 30 minutes of Central Station, arguing about everything and nothing. And that's scene number 85, Philadelphia Penn Station. And so from here, this is the road south. look at the road south using your thumb. So you can take the road south. That would mean hitchhiking, I guess. Then hitching south in a nasty afternoon drizzle. That takes us to Baltimore. Out the door. We can continue hitching. There's no other compass directions on here. And that takes us to Richmond. And Richmond. And this is the long travel sequence. Again. Then we go south to Durham and the Denim. That's Durham. And then Charlotte, which is also her name. Sounds like a little threesome. And then Atlanta. To Atlanta, so they're going the whole completely down the south coast that you're hitchhiking in. Montgomery, it's Alabama, nowhere in general. And eventually it takes us into scene number 86, the outskirts of Montgomery, Alabama. And here's a gas station, a Texaco gas station. But it also indicates the beginning of a new chapter, which is called 13 Steps to Hell. So we're going to pause the game right here. That was chapter 38. It took us across two continents, from London to New York, and then down the East Coast to the south, the Deep South. And that's where we're going to pause the game. This was chapter 38, Next Time in New York, from Beyond Exile. Thank you for watching this, and I hope you continue on.